Her name is Lucy Bloom, and she's best described as a change maker, rule breaker, but also a business fixer.
I've been a speaker now for more than 15 years, and I have never met a theme I cannot speak to. So the client gives me a theme, and I create brand new content for a brand new audience, and I make sure that it relates to their industry and the challenges they're facing now and in the future.
Hi, I'm Dale Beaumont. I'm the founder of Business Blueprint, and I've been hearing amazing things about Lucy Bloom and decided to book her for our latest event. What people have said is that her presentation was dynamic, it was engaging, it was heartfelt, it was authentic, and above all, it was inspirational.
I had a long career in advertising, and then I was the CEO of two international aid charities, and that taught me so much about people and business. My favourite speech of all time is what I call doing business differently, and I think it applies to just about anyone in business and in life. So I explore my favourite themes: courage, kindness, optimism, persistence, failure, and crucially, why fun is important to your bottom line.
Hi, my name is Bernard Solf. The speaking skills of Lucy Bloom, and I will say that speaker to speaker, she is one of the best. She delivers an insight into the human spirit. She has everyone in that room on the edge of their seat, always delivers impact.
I love nothing more than taking a room full of people on a journey, and then I open their minds to new ways of thinking and leave them ready to take action.
I'm not a business as usual kind of lady, I'm more a change maker.
It's the biggest thrill to be that trigger for maverick ideas and for momentum. Conferences are not meant to be dull, and there's a lot of research around humour and the link to memory retention.
Dopamine is an absolute rock star of a hormone, and you produce dopamine when you're falling in love, when you're laughing, or when you're smoking crack cocaine.
So if you want your delegates to remember the juicy content of your conferences and events, you need a funny speaker. Clients often ask me to speak on resilience. So I draw on my personal experiences, some of them really tough ones. I had a motorcycle accident that could have killed me, and I've worked in places like Cambodia and Ethiopia, and the epic challenges of a CEO running small, fast-paced teams. So I take real, relatable experiences that have taught me an enormous amount, and then I give them to my audience so they don't have to go through the pain and suffering that I did.
I've had some major face plants in my career, and I have bounced back every time. So if I can't be an inspiration, I can at least be a horrible warning.
I'm so thrilled to be the poster girl for failure. I speak on how to bounce back from failure better than ever with my 5 steps for success.
Hi, my name's Sarah Nally, and I was the founder of Wired for Wonder. The thing I love about Lucy is that she really cares about making sure that she really delivers a great experience for your audience. She just knows how to really read a room and take people on a learning adventure. Yeah, I look for opportunities to put her on a stage again and again and again, because my audience of over 2,000 absolutely loved her.
I show audiences how to be resilient and to create value even when they're facing adversity and constant change. So I let them laugh at themselves and at their profession, and we look at out-of-industry examples for success factors and ideas, and then I leave them feeling supercharged to take action, tweeting their hearts out.
To speak about courage,
I have never jumped out of a plane into a war zone. I've never stood in front of a firing squad. I've never had to walk out of a violent marriage. I've only been ballsy or courageous in a corporate sense, or maybe in a hairdressing sense.
So many industries are in a sudden state of change and reinvention, and I believe that the winners in the future will be really courageous and brave. So technology might facilitate the change, but you need to nurture courage and pluck and bravery in your people.
If you want someone to do something, you need to make them uncomfortable to do it. If at the end of a speech I've given and everyone goes, "Oh, that was interesting," I have not done my job. But if you feel motivated, pushed to do something, change something, something I've said has given you like a discomfort, like, need to fix that, then I've done my job.